That's right, guys. You've tuned back into MTD CNC North America, and today I'm with my buddy John, and we're talking Factory Whiz. Now, Factory Whiz is an incredible company. They really help support the industry when it comes to understanding the tribal knowledge and bringing people together and understanding the up times and the down times and everything that goes along with the quoting of a customer, anything within the industry, within your shop, that's kind of the hidden secrets that we're trying to pull out and make more common. So John is going to help us understand utilizing both perspectives, sitting on both sides of the fence of how it can help you implement it in your facility and where he sees the benefits based on coming from machining and now being in sales and some of the questions you get in the sales world, now working for Factory Whiz, that we can answer for some of the folks out there. Where do you see some of these questions that people are asking you now that you've transferred over, and where do you see the benefits of something like Factory Whiz?
I see a lot of the questions coming into, should we do this? What is IIoT? What is Industry 4.0? What is data? And we say that term almost, people get scared, data. But you know what? You inspect a part, and if you write that down, that's data. If you write a program, that's data. We're talking about collecting another sort of data. First off, everybody gets all excited about connecting to machines. How do you connect to the machine? How do we get this out? We do that all the time. That's any machine monitoring company worth their salt can hook to machines. We do brand new machines, plug and connect. We also do the old machines. How do you do a 30-year-old cutoff saw on the corner with a little hydraulic cylinder where you adjust it? But we have ways of doing that. But if that saw affects your production, if you're feeding another machine tool with the material that's coming off that saw, maybe that saw is an important thing to monitor. And what are we getting from that? When is it running? When is it not? Did it make a part? Some of the newer machines were pulling offsets. We're pulling alarms. We're pulling things like that. But to really understand, are you up, are you down, the percentage, that's the type of data. And I think people get overwhelmed by that, data collection and data analysis. I'm a machine shop. I got the particle protector, my name on the thing, I'm making parts, that's what I do. Data collection, that's not what I do. But by understanding what your shop is doing, I think you can make better decisions on what you're running.
So two things I think about when you say that. One, with data, I think of Star Trek, The Next Generation, that really pale robot data, right? Full of information, very necessary.
Exactly.
That kind of thing, right? Also, it takes me back to my days in a machine shop, and I'm going to give a super quick example, if that's okay. When I used to make jewelry, I would make hundreds of wedding bands. At the end of the day, I would go, okay, I made, pick a number, hundreds, an easy number to do. Yep. I worked an 8-hour shift, I made 100 rings, I divide my minutes or I divide my hours and the number of rings that I made, mathematically I know I made X amount of parts per minute or per hour during my shift. But what Factory Whiz does is it doesn't just do that basic math. That to me is so basic. It tells me nothing about how long it took me to physically punch in a program or edit a program or set up the machine or change from one job to another job. All of that is data, and we don't need to be scared of the word, because as you've already said, if I take a caliper and I measure a part and I write down the dimensions of that part, that's data.
Yeah.
If I put into my machine a program and I change an offset, that's data.
Exactly.
It's all data. We're just utilizing different words, where I call it an offset or I call it a result and we call it data. It's all information that we need, and we don't need to be afraid of it.
I agree. But your example of what you did in the machine shop, if you took the number of parts and you divided it out because you wanted to see how good you can do so you can compare that to the next day. So you sat down. Well, while you were doing that, you weren't really making any parts, were you? Can you imagine at 7 o'clock in the morning, a report automatically shows up that did the same calculation that you just described to me? Because that's important, as well as the other things you pointed out. But now if that report shows up right in your inbox automatically every morning or every week, how did that save you time? Okay? And I don't know that people think about that. Yes, we look and how do we get better, but Factory Whiz can do some of that work for you. A lot of different reports, but even as easy as what you just said, that was still work that you put into to get that number. Factory Whiz could do that work for you.
Valuable, John. Valuable, valuable stuff, because you're right. Even though it wasn't my job to do that, it is somebody's job to collect that information. And if it's given to us automatically by software like FactoryWiz, how much time does that free up for us to focus on other aspects of our company?
That's right. That's right. And to compare it. You know, another report. How did I do Monday versus Tuesday versus Wednesday? Not to even speak of where you went. How long did it take me to set up? Now, it's funny, we often think of FactoryWiz and machine monitoring is what's that cycle time and how often is that running? Well, in a shop like we're going here with machines and tables that are frankly bigger than me and you, I mean, people could even stand on that table. It's not about the cycle time. You're only going to make two parts a day. It's about the setup time. It's about the programming time. And FactoryWiz can track that for you as well. So if you're making a lot of parts, it's one set of data. You're only making, you know, high mix, low volume, it's a different set of data. But it's all data, it's all in a great big database, and you can pull out what works for you depending on the machine or the type of part that you're running.
I don't know if you're anything like me, John, but Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, I kick butt. Monday, I was recovering from the weekend, and Friday, I was ready for the next weekend. But
That's Tuesday, right.
Wednesday, and Thursday, my numbers were up.
That's right. And Monday, I can look at those reports as I'm kicking back.
Well, John, thank you for helping us understand data in general, how this data can help benefit us, and hopefully we understand that we don't need to be afraid of data because it's information that we're already doing, whether consciously or subconsciously, we're implementing it every single day. It's just a matter of going, now I have somebody else to do it, and now I have somebody else to do it correctly and quicker without the assumptions and the guesswork.
Yeah, I agree. A lot of people will, what do you do with the data? We talk about the reports. Reports is just one aspect. You know, you have a big database full of information. To have reports show up automatically is one way to use that data. You can see we've got dashboards around this shop. This company has really embraced the visuality, how's that for a word, of that information. Frankly, just putting a dashboard in front of a group of operators will make them want to do a little bit more. So there's benefits there. Taking that data and sharing it with other software platforms, MES, ERP systems. And it's a two-sided exchange. There's information that an ERP system can give FactoryWiz. Can we have your part number? Can we have the machine that you wanted on? But now we can tell them, hey, this was the cycle time. This is who made it. This is how many parts. So that information is going back and forth. Frankly, Tony, that's IIoT. That's Industry 4.0. It's data. It's sharing that data, not just hoarding it, but sharing it among multiple platforms. That's what we're doing here.
Well, guys, I hope you're excited about this information or as excited about this information as I am. FactoryWiz.com, give them a Google, give them a search, look into it a little bit more. If you have not started implementing some sort of machine metrics into your company, some sort of ERP into your company, it is time to start looking. The industry is growing. We're moving quicker. Where there's more lights out machining. There's more machines. There's smaller parts, tighter tolerances, longer cycle times even on bigger parts. The game is all sorts of fun. And FactoryWiz is one of the leaders when it comes to helping support your company. FactoryWiz.com, give them a shout. Give my buddy John a shout. Give my buddy Rich, Dom, all the team a shout. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. Thanks, John. Really appreciate you being here.
Thanks for having me, Tony.